Hasn't the city learned from its mistakes?
It was a huge embarrassment for the city of Seattle. Millions spent on public toilets that turned into drug dens and were used for prostitution. They were eventually sold on eBay.
We acknowledge that was a failure, but our problem hasn't gone away.
Gary Johnson with the Office of Planning and Community Development says it would have been easy to never consider public toilets again. But they were approached by residents in the U-district and Ballard who say there's still a need for some sort of public bathroom.
It was hard. And, you know, I've got to say that I credit the city with a willingness to reengage in response to these neighborhood concerns and not just saying, oh no, been there, done that. We politically, that failure was really difficult and we're not going there again.
The city of Portland said it studied Seattle's failure to come up with the design for the Portland Loo. Now community members like Rudy Risler say Seattle can redeem itself by bringing that design here.
You can see if there are people inside, you can see how many people are inside. You might be able to see what they're doing. But not really the details.
Risler spent months walking the neighborhoods, talking with people, and looking for the perfect spot.
People have to go and they will go, you know, you can't just avoid it.
They think this location across from the UW campus near 43rd and 15th could be just right. With the campus and light rail stations nearby, he thinks the U-Loo, as they're calling it, will be used by a wide variety of people. And he points out those light rail stations don't have bathrooms.
Well, you have to go. And there are public restrooms, and it's a shame that we don't have any.
And I did talk to Sound Transit about why they don't have bathrooms at those stations. They said because they've had problems with crime and other illicit activities at the bathrooms, and that's why they don't put bathrooms in their stations. Now, as for the cost of the U-Loo and the other bathroom they're going to have here in Ballard, it's going to be $100,000 just for the structure. Then there's going to be additional costs for the transportation and for setting it up here. They don't know those final costs right now. They're looking into how much it's going to cost to dig it and to put the plumbing here. They said at this point, maintenance will likely be the biggest cost. They're still getting bids on that right now. If it goes well in these two locations, they would eventually like to see them in other parts of Seattle. We're live in Ballard. Amy Marino, King 5 News.